Okay, so you've just looked at setting up your Filmora, and now we're going to look at actually importing your files and getting them into your editor. Now with Filmora, you can either drag and drop, which we will do with this one. You can drag and drop straight onto the timeline or up into your folder. And here you can see we've now got this file. And as you can see, because the file is larger than what we set it to, it has automatically made a proxy file. So we're now going to import another through media files. You can also do folders, but we're just going to do a file at the moment. So we just grab our file and click open. This is now in here and it has started making the proxy file. You can also import with the instant cutter tool and it will close your Filmora. And now if we grab our next file, you can also import the same way by using this open file button up here. And now you can see our file is in here. So this is a good way to bring in and rename all your files before you get into Filmora. If we decided that we don't want that first few seconds, we can either drag this up to where it was, or we can click this button down here, and that will bring it to there. We can also do the end, so say if we only want this much, this is now how much we get of this. You can also add new segments, so I can add a segment and say that I want to export this as a separate video. When I click export, it's going to ask me where I want to put it, so we're just going to put it into Filmora output. So this is when it's done and we're going to upload it into Filmora. Great, so that's done and it's now opened these up in our output and also put them into our Filmora project. We're now just going to drag and drop our main file in here and that will start making a proxy. Now you can work on them before the proxy is finished. Now you can put them into your timeline before the proxy is finished, but we're not going to do that yet. We're just going to look at organizing them. At the moment, all of these files are in this folder. We can click down here to make a new folder, where maybe we want our B-roll, and now we can either import into here or we can select these. And I'm gonna hold Command and click this final one to select that as well. And I'm just gonna drag it in to B-roll. This is now in both of these files. We can also filter what we are seeing to see only videos, images, or audio files. We're gonna leave ours on all because we wanna see all the files that we have in here. We can also edit how this is laid out by changing the thumbnail sizes or changing it to list view. I'm going to leave mine on large thumbnail view. And you can also change what they're sorted by, to sort them by the name of the file, the duration, so how long it is, when it was made, and things like that. You can also group them by the type of file, the date created, and the camera name, as well as the duration. So I would usually have mine on none, but for the purposes of this, I'm going to set it to duration, and I'm going to change it to descending. So now you can see it's put my videos into 5 minutes to 30 minutes, and there's one of them, and then less than 1 minute, and there's 4 of them. You also have your shared media folder. So if you have things that are part of your branding, like an overlay, a lower third, or a YouTube end screen, then you can drag these or upload these into your shared media file and upload these. We now have a lower third and a YouTube subscribe animation into our shared media folder. So these will be available throughout all of our projects. Once you know what files you want to use, you can bring these onto the timeline either by dragging it in, or you can select where you want it. So if we wanted to start from here, we can click. And then again, if we wanted to end here, we can click. We don't want these, so we're just gonna set them to be at the ends. And now we've selected that we're gonna have the whole clip, we're just gonna drag this into our timeline. This is now asking if we wanna change our project settings to match the resolution and frame rate of the video we've just added. And for us, this is in a different frame rate and the same resolution, so we are gonna change it to this. Most of the time, you're gonna want to change it to your video. But if you're adding something that's in a different frame rate so you can slow it down, or a bigger resolution so you can zoom in on it, then this is when you wouldn't wanna match your project to them settings. Okay, so I hope this helped. If it did, please remember to like the video and subscribe and check out the other videos in this playlist. The next video will be doing basic cuts.